banned foods. I often talk about foods that should be avoided based on nutritional emptiness, premature aging, and even harmful effects. But indeed, some foods are actually banned. They're illegal. I've actually found 13 foods that have been banned for health or ethical reasons around the globe. Let's go through them. Number one, foie gras. Foie gras may be a French delicacy, but it has no place in California. The state recently reinstated a ban on this fatty duck and goose liver, citing the inhumane treatment of livestock as a reason for the prohibition. The birds are force-fed through tubes in order to enlarge the liver up to 10 times its normal size. Animal rights organizations such as PETA are celebrating the ban, while many Californian chefs and livestock farmers are eager to see it overturned. In addition to California, Italy, India, Denmark, Finland, Norway, Poland, Israel, and Germany all have bans or restrictions on foie gras. Number two, haggis. Another international delicacy, the U.S. prohibits this Scottish pudding, which is made from the sheep's heart, liver, and lungs. It was originally only eaten by peasants, and it's now, in fact, Scotland's national dish. In 1971, the United States Department of Agriculture ruled against the consumption of livestock's lungs, making haggis an illegal dish to serve in the States. Although the Scottish government has been trying to negotiate a change, this law remains intact and haggis continues to be banned nearly half a century later. Number three, beluga caviar. Costing upwards of $200 per ounce, beluga caviar is not only unpopular by price, but also because it is outlawed in the United States to protect the endangered species. These pricey fish eggs come from the beluga sturgeon, a critically endangered fish that is found primarily in the Caspian and Black Sea basins. In an effort to reduce poaching, the United States has banned the importation of beluga caviar since 2005. Here's one for you. Number four, ketchup. Yes, ketchup. You may love dousing your burger with it, but the French school children would get in serious trouble. In 2011, the nation introduced new nutritional guidelines into the schools, in which included the restriction on the sweet tomato-based sauce. In an effort to preserve French culinary traditions, students are only allowed to consume the ketchup with French fries, and they're served these only weekly. Now, the ketchup is made of 25% sugar, and I think a lot of my viewers don't realize how much sugar is in it, and that's why people put it on just about everything. It's actually a sugar addiction. So this isn't a bad reason that it's banned, but in fact, it's banned for cultural reasons. Now, number five, we get to some nice sweets. Everyone loves M&Ms. Candy-coated chocolates are no one's idea of health food, but that's not what's causing Sweden to nix them. Instead, the nation is banning the sale of M&Ms because a court ruled that the candy's branding is too similar to another chocolate-covered peanut snack, M by Mondelez. The company has been selling their delicacies in Sweden since 1957 and objected to M&M's similar name and logo. Now in Canada, we have something that are called Smarties. I like Smarties better than them all. There's no peanuts in them, but if you're ever up there, go try Smarties. Number six, in keeping with our theme with sweets, is chewing gum. Which country do you think? Well, it's Singapore. They're known for their cleanliness. And when it comes to stray gum, they're not fooling around. The country outlawed chewing gum in 1992 in an effort to keep the streets clean and free of stains. Vendors who choose to sell the banned substance risk a sentence of up to 2 years in prison or fines as high as $1,000. Pretty steep for chewing gum. Keep that in mind if you go over there. Number 7, sassafras oil. Now, once the main flavoring component to root beer, this oil is now banned in the United States because it's a known carcinogen. An excess amount of the substance has been linked to kidney and liver damage and has also been used as a hallucinogen comparable to MDMA. For those that don't know, this is ecstasy. This oil can also cause, therefore, euphoria and extreme pleasure similar to ecstasy. If you're craving a root beer float, don't worry, the modern day root beers don't have it, but if you're craving one from olden times, you know exactly what it is you're craving. It's not the sugar, it's that euphoric feeling. So yes, there is a black market for this. Number 8, fugu, one of the world's most dangerous fish. Fugu can literally kill you if it is not prepared correctly. You may have seen these on TV documentaries like I have. 23 people have died in Japan after eating it since 2000, according to the government figures. Most of the victims are anglers, fishermen, who bravely try to prepare their catch at home. It needs to be prepared in a very special way. Tetrodotoxin, which is the poison, has been described as rapid and violent. First, you get a numbness around the mouth, and then a paralysis, and of course, that leads to death. The Japanese delicacy contains this toxin, a poison. It's 12,000 times more deadly than cyanide. Cyanide's one of the most potent toxins out there. Less than a pea-sized amount is enough to kill someone. In fact, a pin-sized amount has been recorded and reported to have killed a person. A pin size. That's why the United States forbids the sale or preparation of fugu without a license. Number 9, to no one's surprise, shark fins. Fins from as many as 73 million sharks end up in the market every year. Although shark finning is illegal in the US waters, fins could still be bought and sold throughout much of the United States. These fins are often imported from countries that have inadequate protections in place for the sharks, and they are endangered in some areas. The sale and consumption of shark fin, which is primarily used in soup and Chinese fine dining, is already off limits in California. The Shark Fin Sales Elimination Act was recently introduced in Congress, which outlaws the sale of shark fins across the country. Advocates of the bill believe it will help protect the shark species and prohibit the inhumane practice of chopping the fins off of these live sharks, which then causes them to die slow and painfully. Number 10, raw milk. You wouldn't think it, but unpasteurized milk, which is raw milk, has been illegal to sell across state lines for nearly 30 years. The American Medical Association and the Center for Disease Control and Preventive Medicine both strongly advise avoiding this kind of milk due to the potential of some risks of foodborne illnesses. While unpasteurized dairy is off limits in America, many European countries regularly consume raw milk, including nations like Austria, Switzerland. They have installed vending machines that distribute it. I've had it before. I actually like the taste of it. Number 11, back to candies, and I love these things, the Kinder Surprise Eggs. You must know them and recall them. I remember getting them as a kid, but these British imports are banned from the US, and not for their tendency to become addictive from the chocolate, but instead, these treats are off limits in America because they contain an inedible object in the center, which violates the Food and Drug Administration's regulations. They are considered to be a choking hazard because young children may mistakenly try to eat the toy in the center of the chocolate. Number 12, RBGH. Canada, Israel, and the European Union all ban RBGH. This genetically engineered hormone is designed to increase milk production in cows suffering mental and physical strain from cattle cramp conditions. RBGH has been shown to cause antibiotic resistance and a higher incidence of disease in cows, which has prompted its ban in many countries. Next is farm-raised salmon. Everyone's favorite pink-hued fish has a dark side, at least when it comes to the farm-raised variety that I talked about in my complete video. Also known as Atlantic salmon, these fish pose a number of environmental concerns, according to the Environmental Defense Fund. Nations including New Zealand and Australia have banned the sale and the consumption of the farm-raised salmon in an effort to reduce pollution. When it comes to grocery shopping, avoid the salmon with the grayish hue. Gravitate towards the one that's labeled sockeye or Alaskan and make sure you're eating the wild variety. Astaxanthins are very important and you don't want the synthetic ones that are often used in those that are farmed. Last, an honorable mention goes to sea bass. I mention this because I know so many people I go out to dinner with order the healthy option and they order the sea bass. It's a popular choice at any upscale restaurant around the country, but this is not the case in Great Britain. A year ago, the country proposed banning the commercial fishing of Atlantic sea bass due to a dramatic reduction in the species population. The same proposal suggested restricting the sale of Celtic cod and Irish sole for similar reasons. I grew up on the East Coast and we ate those and I know they were overfished. While the ban has not gone into effect as of yet, there's a good chance that these seafood favorites will be off limits to diners in Great Britain. That's what we're talking about here in the years to come. So don't be too scared. It's unlikely to happen in this country. But there you go, a list of banned foods. I want to make our viewers aware of different foods, nutritional values, because it plays a big role in how we feel, how we look aesthetically, but also our inner health, because our inner health determines our outward health. Stay tuned here. I put a complete playlist up here, things you can do at home to keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.